So basically, diamagnetism can be explained by the effect, Meissner effect. And this zero resistance property can be explained by BCL's theory. So these two theory will explain the superconducting nature of your material. One is BCS theory, which explains the zero resistivity property of the superconductor, and another one is Meissner effect, which will explain the diamagnetic nature of the superconductor. Okay. So if it is normal conductor, what will happen? Your magnetic lines will transfer or will go through the applied magnetic field. If it is superconductor, what will happen? Magnetic flux lines will be rippled by the applied or external magnetic field. This effect is known as Meissner effect. So, or magnetic field la vekkiringa avanga superconductor vekkiringa material vekkiringa na what will happen? Magnetic flux lines vandu enna agum? Ripple agum. So, adhu dhaan Meissner effect. And the effect of magnetic field. If you are applying strong magnetic field, what will happen? If you are applying small magnetic field or low magnetic field, what will happen? Flux line will be rippled, right? If you are applying strong, very strong magnetic field, what will happen? Entire superconducting phenomena will vanish. Okay, nairo. Entire superconducting phenomena will be destroyed. Adhe nairo destroyed, your material will become a normal conductor. Okay, so if you are applying strong magnetic field, so strong magnetic field means it will destroy the superconducting phenomena. Low magnetic field means magnetic lines will be rippled. So if you are applying magnetic field, your superconducting material will behave accordingly. Okay, low magnetic field kudutinga enna agum? Flux lines vandu. What is your question? Suppose temperature and critical temperature equal means. What kind of temperature you are asking? It won't be equal. Okay, if you are increasing temperature or if you decreasing temperature, your normal material will become a superconductor at a particular temperature. That temperature is known as critical temperature. Okay, so equilibrium temperature will be differ from critical temperature. It won't be equal, it will be different, and it also depend on the material you are considering. Okay, what kind of material we are choosing, either oxides or actinides, these parameter will play important role while calculating the critical temperature. But your temperature means you are asking without any specification, right? Here temperature is nothing but 0 Kelvin to some other Kelvin, right? You can increase your temperature up to thousands of Kelvin, isn't it? So at a particular temperature, at a specific temperature, your material will become a superconductor. That temperature is known as critical temperature. It won't be 0 Kelvin. Of course, it won't be 0 Kelvin. Is it clear?